लेट अस परफॉर्म कैलिब्रेशन ऑफ सिंगल फेज एनर्जी मीटर। सिंगल फेज एनर्जी मीटर इज ए मीटर विच मेजर्स अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी कंज्यूम्ड बाय ए सिंगल फेज डोमेस्टिक कस्टमर एंड इट गिव्स मंथली टैरिफ टू द कंज्यूमर। ओके, इट रिकॉर्ड्स द डेटा फॉर वन मंथ एंड इट डिलीवर्स द टैरिफ। सो लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द ऑपरेटर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू परफॉर्म आवर सिंगल फेज एनर्जी मीटर कैलिब्रेशन। हियर कैन सी we need an energy meter which is of induction type and the range is 3200 revolutions per kilowatt hour. This is the meter constant and we are going to need a voltmeter to measure the supply voltage which is of 0 to 300 volts range and a meter of 10 amps range. Both are digital type and a resistive load which has rotary switches. So we are going to apply these resistive load on the energy meter and we are going to see how the meter reacts, and we are going to need a stopwatch to count how much time it is taking to revolve 10 times for each and every load, and a single phase variac which is a variable voltage supply, that is auto transformer of 0 to 270 volts by 10 amps range and connecting wires as required. Let us see circuit diagram. See, we will be needing a variac which is auto transformer. So the supply is connected to variac, and after the variac we are going to connect a voltmeter to measure the supply voltage, and there are four terminals for a energy meter which are two pairs of phase and neutrals. One pair is at source end, another pair is at load end. Source end has phase and neutrals and load side has phase and neutral as well. The P1 N1 are source side terminals of energy meter, P2 N2 are load side terminals of energy meter. So we are going to give the supply to P1 N1 through the auto transformer, and the load terminals are connected to P2 and N2. You can see an ammeter is connected at the load side to measure the load current, and you can see the resistors are connected through switches which are a resistive load. Okay, we are going to turn on each and every resistance value and we are going to see how the meter is reacting. There is a disc in the induction type energy meter where it rotates based on the amount of load. If the load is more on the meter, the disc rotates faster. Okay, as we increase the load, the speed of the induction disc will be increased. Okay, so we will be finding the number of the amount of time taken for 10 revolutions for each and every load, by using which we can calculate meter constant, which is number of revolutions per kilowatt hour, and we are going to compare the data with theoretical data, then we can find percentage error. This is calibration of single phase energy meter. Let us see the procedure. First of all, we have to make the connections as per the circuit diagram. That is, we have to connect sub source to the variac, single phase variac, and we have to connect a voltmeter parallel with the variac to measure the supply voltage, and we have to connect the phase and neutral of our source side to the variac. The load side terminals are to be connected to the ammeter and resistive load. This is the connection to be made. After the connections, keep the auto transformer knob at zero position. Now switch on the 230 volts AC, then increase the input voltage by rotating the auto transformer in clockwise direction. Adjust the resistive load so that the sufficient current flows in the circuit, and please note that the current should be less than 5 amps, because 5 amps is the maximum current that to be allowed in the meter. So we should not increase the current greater than 5 amps. That will damage the meter if we increase greater than 5 amps. So note down the voltmeter and ammeter readings for different loads as per the tabular column. And we have to find out how much time it is taking for 10 revolutions of each load. That means the rotating disk in the energy meter rotates 10 times, and we are going to calculate the amount of time it is going to take for 10 revolutions for each load. After the completion of experiment, bring back the auto transformer to initial position and switch off the supply. Let us see tabular form. Here you can see it contains first column as serial number, second as applied load. The load is in amps here. Okay, the load is not in ohms, here it is in amps. And we are going to find out the voltmeter reading, which is connected across the variac, ammeter reading, which is connected at the load side, number of revolutions of the disk, which is constant, 10 revolutions, and time taken for 10 revolutions for each and every load. Okay, that is, in the second column, you can see the applied load. For 1 amp load, it is making 10 revolutions and taking 41 seconds. If we increase the load to 2 amps, it is taking just 19 seconds to rotate 10 times. That is, the speed of the disk has been increased from 1 amp load to 2 amp load. Okay, the speed is proportional to the load here. Then you can calculate energy consumed by using this data. And you can calculate percentage error. Let us see the calculations. The meter constant is given by number of revolutions per kilowatt hour. Here we have number of revolutions as 3200 revolutions. That means the meter constant is 3200. And the energy recorded is given by this equation. So the percentage error can be found out using these expressions. So these are the precautions you must take. There should be not any loose connections while connecting the circuit diagram. You should not connect the connections to any loose. Okay, make sure that there is no loose connection. Meter readings should not be exceeded beyond the ratings. Here we have 5 amps rating, so the current should not lead beyond the 5 amps. So take the readings perfectly. So this is the model graph between percentage error and load current. This is the model graph between percentage error and load current. Result is, the calibration of single phase energy meter has been done and error is calculated. Thank you. Students, now we are going to perform calibration of single phase energy meter. Here you can see this is single phase energy meter. You are very aware of this. Every domestic electric supply is measured with using this single phase energy meter. This is of induction type. Okay, you know that this is integrating type instrument. You know the types of instruments are like indicating, recording, integrating, right? This is integrating type instrument. That is, it integrates each and every value and stores the data in it. Now we are going to see how the circuit connections are made for single phase energy meter calibration. Here you can see this is single phase variac. Variac is auto transformer, which is also called as a dimmer, which is having 270 volts rating. For single phase, we are going to apply 230 volts. This single phase variac is supplied from the source. Okay, now I am going to measure the voltage across this single phase variac using a voltmeter. Here I am going to connect this voltmeter in parallel with the variac, and I want to measure the load current. So I have to connect a ammeter in series with this variac. I am going to connect the positive terminal of our variac to positive terminal of our ammeter. Here you can see this black color wire is connecting positive terminal of our variac to positive terminal of this ammeter, and I am going to connect this negative terminal to phase. Here you can see there are 4 terminals in our energy meter.
these two are our source side or supply side terminals. One is phase and another is neutral, and these two are load side terminals. This is phase and this is neutral. So you are having two pairs of phase and neutrals here. Okay, I am going to connect the negative terminal of our ammeter to the phase terminal, and I am going to connect the neutral terminal of our source side terminal of energy meter to negative terminal of neutral terminal of our variac. Okay, and on the load side, this blue color is connecting to the load positive terminal. Here you can see this is a single phase resistive load which is having 10 amps rating. When I turn on this switch to on position, this circuit will connect to the energy meter. When I switch each and every knob here, 1 amp resistance will be added to this load. You can see if I turn on all the knobs to on position, the 10 amps load will be applied on the energy meter. Now what we are going to perform is, we are going to apply load on our energy meter using this resistive load, and these knobs indicate 1 amps load on the our energy meter. If I turn on one knob, 1 amp load will be applied on the energy meter. If I turn on all the knobs, 10 amps load will be applied on the energy meter. So step by step, I am going to turn on each and every knob to on position, and I am going to measure how much time it is taking to this energy meter to rotate 10 times. You can see this is a disc here. So I am going to calculate the time for 10 revolutions for each load. I am going to increase the load and I am going to repeat the same step. I am going to increase the load to 2 amps and I am going to measure how much time it is taking for 10 revolutions using a stopwatch. Okay, this is a stopwatch. I am going to measure how much time it is taking for 10 revolutions. Okay, and I am going to calculate meter constant using the data and percentage error. Okay, so here you can see this is supplied to our board. If I turn on this MCB to this position, there you can see the indication in the bulb. So we got supply here, we got supply up to this position. In order to get supply to our variac, we have to switch on this switch to up position. Now you can see a bulb is indicating our supply to the variac. Okay, we have supplied the variac, single phase variac, so which is at zero position initially. I have to rotate the variac to get rated voltage. For single phase voltage supply, it is of 230 volts. Okay, here you can see this is, the wire is connected at 300 volts. That means we have 150 volts here. For every single digit, it is assumed as double of its value. So for 230 volts, I have to increase it to 115 volts. Okay, you can see now I have increased the voltage to 115 volts. That means it is having 230 volts supply. You can see no deflection in the ammeter because I have not applied any load on the energy meter. Okay, you can see there is no deflection, there is no rotation in the energy meter. If I turn on the load on the energy meter, step by step, you can see the changes in ammeter and disc readings. Okay, you can see this blink, this light indicating we are turning on the load. So I have applied 1 amp load. You can see the disc is rotating. Okay, see here I am going to measure the time taken for 10 revolutions of disc. Okay, for I am going to start for red. Wait, I am going to start the stopwatch when I see the red mark on the disc. Ready, 1, 2, 3, go. Now I have started the stopwatch. I will wait till our disc rotates 10 times and I am going to stop the stopwatch after 10 revolutions. It may take a while. So now it has revolved for 9 times. This is the 10th time. You can see the time here, 3:55. I am going to switch off the stopwatch when I see the red color. Okay, now you can see it took 4 minutes to revolve 10 rounds. Okay, first 1 amp load. Now I am going to increase the load to 5 amps, 4 and 5. Okay, now you can see the speed of the disc has been increased. You can see the speed. Okay, now I am going to measure the current. Sorry, I am going to measure the time. 1 have started, 2, now it is moving fast, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, see, you can see the time for 10 revolutions for 10 amp, 5 amps load. So initially it was 4 minutes for 1 amp load. When I increased the load to 5 amps, it took 38 seconds, just 38 seconds to rotate 10 times. That means as we are increasing the load, the current in the ammeter, the load current is increasing, okay, and the speed of the disc is increasing. That means as the load is increased, the speed of the rotation of the disc is increasing. So it measures the load current, load voltage, and gives the amount of energy consumed by the customer. Okay, so by using this data, we are going to calculate percentage error of energy and meter constant of our single phase energy meter. So the meter constant is number of revolutions per kilowatt hour, that we are going to calculate using the data. Okay, this step is going to be repeated for 10 seconds also, 10 amps load. So I have applied the full load on the energy meter. You can see the how fast the meter is rotating now. Now it is rotating very fast. You can see the red color mark is coming very fast. So that is, as we have increased the load on the meter, you can see the deflection in the ammeter, that is nearly, voltmeter is constant, ammeter reading is nearly 9.5 amps. So the meter is rotating fast, that is it is integrating the values and it is calculating the energy. Okay, so as we have done with the experiment, I am going to turn off the load gradually to off positions. Okay, I am going to turn off the load, and to switch off the supply, I am going to reduce the voltage applied on the variac to 0 position. Okay, you can see the deflection in the voltmeter, that comes to 0 position. Then I am going to switch off the MCB here.